Hey, it's Kat. We're talking about components today. So components are a specific type of object that allows user interaction and allows us to set up things like forms. Here we've got a small example of a graphical user interface that has used some components. So first of all, we've got 1, 2, 3 labels. We have here what's called a choice menu. So it's just referred to as choice. These little dudes here are referred to as checkbox. There's an X there. This is a text field. And we've also got a button. Because they are all objects, they're all declared with a capital letter. Text field's a bit strange, it's actually got a capital T and a capital F. As with any objects, the components need to be declared in the class. They also need to be instantiated and initialized. The other thing that we need to do with them is we need to add them to the screen. So declaration happens in the class, and the other two happen in init. As we saw with both the color object and the font object, each different object type needs different information in order for it to be created. So a color needed red, green, and blue. A font needed font information. And the same is true for all these different screen components. So we'll have a quick summary of what each of those will require in order to be created. To create a text field, we need to specify how big the field is. That's not necessarily how many items it can contain, but it is how big the field appears. With a text field also, if we want to, we can set some text in there. And if we do that, we need to put it in the double quotes. With a label, because it's basically static text, we need to give it some text that's going to appear on the screen. A button also has text that appears on the button itself. With a choice menu, you first create the choice menu, and then after that, you add each of the items that you want in that menu. With the checkbox, you actually create it as a checkbox group. Once you've created it as a checkbox group, then you add checkboxes to it, and each checkbox that you then add has different values. For this to make more sense, we'll have a look at each of these specific items in Eclipse. So we're looking at Eclipse, and what I've done is created a new class called Components, and again I've just popped that in my project Java Basic Objects. So in here, let's just look at each of the different components one by one. So we'll start off with a basic label. So we would declare that we're going to have a label, and just looking at the little example that I gave earlier, maybe I'll use name label. So a prompt that will tell somebody that they are to enter their name. Now, the name that I've chosen indicates what the label is going to be about, and I've also put label in the name. That's not necessary, but for me, it's indicating to me what it's a label for. Particularly when I'm creating a program that has multiple labels, it's good to indicate which one is which. That would declare that I am creating a label
I've called it name label, but so far it does not yet exist. So I need to, I've done my declaration, I need to instantiate and initialize. So I say name label equals, sorry, I keep misspelling, label equals new label. And as I said, this one expects text. So this is the text that's going to appear. So I will say enter your name. Now I've added a space in there as well because when I add components to the screen, they just add one after the other. So if I don't have that space, my label might be too close to whatever the next component is. I'll put a semicolon there. And to actually get that to appear on the screen, I put add and then the component name. So I called it name label and we'll plop that there. Just run that one. And it has put my label on the screen. It's important to note that as you create multiple components and you add them, they add in the order in which you use this command. So if I said add name label, add name text field, add whatever, the name label would appear first, then the text field. And they add to the screen from top left, then to the right of that, to the right of that, if the screen isn't wide enough, it then adds below. So it keeps adding them together from left to right. So let's have a look at a different component. Let's maybe create a text field. Now it's really important to remember there's a capital T and a capital F. Programming is case sensitive, so it's really important that no matter what you do, you use the correct case, otherwise you will get errors. So I'm going to have a name input. For me personally, if I've put a text field there, I've put it there to accept input from the user. And in this case, I'm accepting a name, so I've called it name input. As I've said, you do not need to give it that name as long as you know what you've called it and why you've called it that. So here I'll put name input equals new text field. And a text field expects a size. So I'm going to make that one 10 pixels wide. Well, it's not 10 pixels, but it's 10, the width of 10 characters. To add that to the screen, I say add name input. And I can run that. And then we have the label, and the text field. Now to just demonstrate what I was saying earlier, if I take where I've added the name label and I move it below the text field, the two should now be in the opposite order. So the order in which you add them is literally the order in which they appear on the screen. So remember to bear that in mind as you work your way through. Now, out of habit, there are a few different ways I would structure my code. First of all, obviously, all my declarations happen in the class. But in public void init, where I do all of this setting up, I'm either going to keep everything for a particular component together, so all the stuff for name label together, all the stuff for name input together, or I would put all my instantiations together and all my adding to the screen together. Both are fine. If you're creating a screen that has a lot of components, it's probably good to put all the adding together so that it's easy to rearrange if you find you've put them down in the wrong order. So, but that is up to you. Okay, let's look at another component. Another one that we have used is the button. So I'm going to go from the easiest ones to the hardest ones. So we've got a button. And in the case of my example, it was to submit a result. So I'm going to call it a submit button. To create my button, I say submit equals new button. And a button expects text. So this is the text as it will appear on the button itself. So I've used a capital S for that one. And I'm going to add that to the screen. Let's just run it. So we've got the label, the text field, and the button. Now the button has appeared to the right of the text field because they both fit across the width of that screen. If I make it really wide, they all fit. If I make it really narrow, they go one below the other. So it, how they appear is determined by the screen size. Okay, let's go for another option. The next easiest one is probably the choice menu. So I would normally refer to that as a drop-down box. So it is called choice. Now the drop-down menu that I had in the example that was given, it was allowing somebody to select their age. So again, I view this as input. You're getting information from the user. So I'll call mine age input. Remembering you can give it whatever name you would like. In public void init, I'm just separating this out a little bit because age input, my choice menu, it can't be done in one simple line. It actually requires a few lines. So I'm going to put it on its own there. So age input equals new choice. And that gets it ready. It sets it up a little bit and goes, okay, I know there's more information coming. Now to add more information, I refer to age input. And then I access some of the methods that relate to that object type. And I'm adding items to the menu. And in there, I'll put in double quotes what my items are. Now, I was opting for age because I teach at a college. The age range is typically 16 to 18. So I'm going to go 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19 to cover all the ages there. That piece of code, I can copy and paste that one because the only thing that will change is the number. So I'll go through 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. As I add the items, that is the order in which they appear in that menu. And I'm going to pop that one in my screen. Typically, I would expect a button for submitting an item to be last. So I might put the age input before the submit button, but after they've been expected to enter their name. Okay, let's just have a quick look. So, our label, our text field, our age menu, and our submit button. Okay, the last component we're going to look at is a checkbox group. It's a checkbox group because there is more than one option. If there was only going to be one option, you would use simply a checkbox. So I'm going to declare the checkbox group. And I'm going to call this one gender input because I'm going to provide the options of male or female. Okay. Now, similar to this whole choice thing, the checkbox group has multiple pieces of information. So first of all, we are going to say gender input equals new checkbox group, remembering the capitals, of course, open and close brackets, semicolon. So again, that says I'm going to set this one up. Now, the only strange thing I've found with the checkboxes or radio buttons, whatever you'd like to call them, is like I can't do this add item thing. It works, or it, you may be able to do it, but I haven't found it yet. So I'm actually going to go to where I would add this into my screen. So I'm going to put it between name and age. And here I need to add it to the screen. And then I say in here, new checkbox. I say what the text is that I want for that button option. So I'm going to put mail. After that, I have a comma, and I say I need to tell it which group it belongs to, and it belongs to the gender input group. Now, if I want that checkbox to be selected by default, I would then put true, semicolon. So it's a little bit confusing, but this is the only way that I've seen how to do it so far. I don't use checkboxes very often, and that's why I probably don't know all the best solutions to this one. I'm going to copy that. I'm going to paste it, and I'm going to change the other one to be female. And with checkboxes or radio buttons, typically only one can be selected at a time, so I'll change that to false. So what we should have now on the screen is the name label, the text field, the two radio buttons for female and male. We should then have the drop-down box with the input for age and the submit button at the bottom. Okay, so we've got all those. Remembering that the width of the screen can help you adjust how you would like this to appear. Now, this hasn't provided a whole lot of feedback to the user, so we might add in some extra labels asking them to enter their or select their gender and select their age. So let's just create two more labels. Now, this is where you'll notice that my habit is to put all the labels together, all the text fields together, and so on. So I've got a name label. I'm also going to have a gender label. And I'm going to have an age label. Okay. Again, just the way I work is I'm going to put all my labels together. I'm lazy, so I'm copying and pasting quite a bit. That's fine. Generally, only copy and paste your own code, certainly to start with. So we'll say select your gender. And we've got age label, and we're going to say select your age. Okay, now we want, when we're looking at adding things to the screen, we want to ask for their name and provide an option for input. Then we want to ask for their gender before we give them the input, and we're going to ask for their age before we give them the option to input. So if we run that again, okay, there we go. Now, to make that look good, might need to bump it out a bit. Now, if I want that to pop up a specific size by default in init, one of the first things I do there is set size. I'm not sure how wide this is going to be, so we'll just try a few options. Maybe 200. I think that might be too narrow. So with the sizes, just tweak it a little bit. It'll be different on every computer. There we go. So there is my use of components. Check out the next episode for figuring out how to actually get the input from those fields and options and to deal with it. So this is components, and the next part is events.